Okay, Justin Trudeau did something today that did the unimaginable. I think what Trudeau announced today might actually both increase fuel prices and make climate change worse. So, what did Justin Trudeau do today that could possibly manage both of these things at the same time? Well, as many of you know, Alberta is home to some of North America's most ample supply of energy. And over the last several years, Alberta energy producers have recognized that people want climate change addressed, so they've put emissions caps on their production. In fact, the province and the government of Alberta have been supportive of this. And in Canada, it's actually provincial jurisdiction to say how natural resources should be developed. It's not the federal jurisdiction. Well, recently, Justin Trudeau has said that he wants to put a federal cap on emissions. And of course, many people pushed back on this in Alberta, including frankly, the Alberta NDP. They had proposed a provincial emissions cap themselves. So today, Justin Trudeau, even through all of this, even with gas prices being so expensive, doubled down on this policy. It's just breaking news right now. Now, how could this possibly make climate change worse, you might ask? Well, here's a fact that many people who are writing climate change policy ignore. The world is still a carbon-based economy. And you know this because when you go to fill up your car, you're paying a lot for gas, and it's not like there's another readily available alternative. Certainly in my riding in North Central Calgary, the riding I represent as a member of parliament, there's actually no light rail transit to be able to get downtown to work, for example, right? Many of you have to fill up your cars to get to work, to get your kids around, whatever, right? The second thing is that what fuel costs it impacts things like groceries, right? And what has increased a lot in price over the last little while? Groceries. So by doubling down on a policy that's creating confusion and investment in Canada's energy sector, what does that mean for you? Well, first of all, what it means is that we are offshoring Canadian jobs and we're offshoring demand for carbon energy to other jurisdictions. And this is underscored by 3 points. There's a report that the big commission in the United States issued. Emmanuel Macron and Joe Biden had an aside at the last G7 meeting where Macron was like, "Oh, I talked to the Saudis and I don't think they can increase production, and this is a concern for us on cash and on price for gas." And also, Trudeau is in a lot of hot water for sending Russian turbine parts to Germany for a Russian pipeline. So if we had a non-carbon-based economy where substitute goods existed for things like filling your tank of gas, then why would those things be happening? Why would the French be so concerned about the ability of the Saudis to produce energy, for one thing, right? So we have to get real on this. Now, I wrote a really what I think is a strong essay for you to read through. It's in the video description here, on how the lack of substitute goods, or that's sorry, I'm gonna I have a degree in economics, but the lack of other goods for carbon energy that could replace carbon energy, increasing prices on these things through things like carbon taxes and putting caps on emissions of Canadian energy, which is produced under super high and super strict environmental standards, could actually make climate change worse, because most economists and most models don't show a reduction of demand for carbon energy without having those things in place. And they're not in place right now. So I just encourage you, I ask you to help me in doing my job as a member of parliament, is to click on the link in this video description, read it, and maybe share it with others. Because today, like this emissions cap that he's putting on Alberta energy, everybody wants to address environmental protection in Canada. The question is how? And by keeping increasing the price of gas or the price of energy and making Canada more reliant on energy from other places without having these goods in place, it makes things worse. It makes things more expensive for you. You are not buying less energy, you're just paying more for it. And that's what the Liberals have forgotten, right? And we actually, in a lot of reports, show global emissions continuing to increase in spite of the Liberals curtailing our ability to be self-sufficient on energy here in Canada, and in spite of you paying more for it. So the next time someone tries to talk to you about climate policy, which is something that's important to talk about, read this article that I wrote first, because it talks about how the fact that without alternatives to carbon fuel, paying more for it isn't going to create less demand. It's something called price inelasticity, right? And also share this video. It frustrates me to no end to just let this one very narrow and false band of public policy dominate the debate on Canada's energy sector. And by this band of policy, I mean the Liberals' climate change policy. It frustrates me because there's more to it. And if we want to address price of fuel, the cost of living, jobs in the economy in Canada, and climate change, the Liberals should be paying attention to what I wrote today, not just doubling down on policies that cause us to lose jobs, that cause us to be more reliant on energy produced by countries like Saudi Arabia, Russia, Venezuela, and other countries, and also doesn't address climate change. So, very frustrating day, but I tried to provide you with some information to be able to talk to friends and family about why the Liberals' climate change policy has failed and what are some things that they could be doing to both lower the cost of living for you and to address climate change as well. So read that article, it's in the video description, share this video, and just push back on Justin Trudeau. We don't need policy like this when cost of living is spiraling out of control and we're seeing a global crisis for energy. Working hard for you. Have a great day.